Hello, class. Welcome to Salisbury University Physical Education. My name is Ms. Clemens.
Coach Jones.
Coach Reed.
And I'm Coach Pat. So what you will need for today, you're going to need a paddle, a racket, anything with a small handle, a frying pan, and a sock will do, loose athletic or comfortable clothing, closed-toed shoes, water, listening ears, and as always, some excitement.
All right, everybody, for our instant activity today, we're going to be playing a couple rounds of dice. We played this earlier in the semester, and we're going to come back to it now. What happened to we'll roll some dice. The number it lands on correlates with an activity, and we're going to do that activity for 30 seconds. We're going to go 10 rounds. All right, so we're going to get our first roll right here. And we got a 4, so we're going to do some push-ups. You got 30 seconds worth. Try to get in as many as you can. Good work. If you need to, remember you can modify. Push up from your knees, or you can put your feet out to make it more challenging and do a normal push up. There we go, 10 seconds. Finish strong right here. All right, good work. So we're gonna roll again for round 2. Got a 4 again. We're gonna get real strong today. We're going to hit some more push-ups, 30 seconds worth. Here we go. To make this more challenging, we can move our arms wider. We can move them into a triangle or a diamond. Here we go, 10 seconds. Good work. Try to get as many as you can. All right, we're gonna hit our third roll. Oh, we got a 1, so we're gonna do some jumping jacks. If these are too easy for you, go quicker. See how many you can get. Really push yourselves. Good work, good work. Here we go, 10 seconds. Five. All right, round 4. We're back to the push-ups. We're going to be so strong after this. Here we go, 30 seconds. A lot of push-ups. If you need, push from your knees. Not even going to recognize yourself with these arm muscles right now. Good work, guys. Here we go, 5 seconds. All right, our 5th roll. We're halfway there. 2, so we're going to go with some sit-ups. Give your arms a break. We're going to hit our core this time. This is too challenging. You can use your arms to help pull yourself up. It's not challenging enough. Cross your arms across your chest and really just use your core right here. Good work, 10 seconds. Good job, right? We're on the 6th roll. Gonna hit some more sit-ups. We're gonna be shredded in the arms and having a whole 6-pack after this. Here we go. Really push yourself in these 30 seconds. Get as many as you can. Like stated previously, if you need to modify these in either way, you are more than welcome to. Five. All right, roll number seven. Three, so we're gonna go some single foot jumps. Just pick one foot and jump continuously in place on that one. If you feel the need, you can switch to the other one. Short, quick jumps, short, quick jumps. Good work, everybody. All right, roll number seven. We're still with the single leg jumps. So if you stayed on one, try to switch over to your other leg. If you're confused on what that looks like, right in the middle, there are some video examples. Good work, good work. Push it, last 10 seconds right here. All right, we're on roll number eight. All right, we're gonna get some run in place. So we're just gonna pump our arms and quick feet, quick feet. Really pump your arms in this. Good work, good work. Halfway, push yourself. All right, roll number eight. Back to the sit-ups. Gonna have that beach body in no time. Remember, we're trying to get as many reps in this time as we possibly can. You're doing amazing. Keep at it. 10 seconds. Here we go. All right, roll number nine. We're back to the single leg jumps. We should have done both legs by now, so whichever one you feel needs the more work, go ahead and stay on that one. These are short and quick jumps. We don't want height, we want speed. Good work, everyone. 10 seconds, here we go. You should feel it burning in your calves. Here we go. All right, final spin. And we're ending it with the jumping jacks. 30 seconds, as many as you can. Here we go. Good work, everyone. Ten seconds, everything you got. 5 seconds. Here we go, here we go. Quick feet. Good work.
So what are we learning today? Today we will strike objects using a shorthanded implement while demonstrating proper cues of each movement. We will also explain the importance of cardiovascular endurance for the body. We will also demonstrate independence by completing lesson activities on your own. These correspond with grade level outcomes S1, E2, 4, 4A, strike an object with the shorthanded implement while demonstrating a mature pattern. S3, E3, 4, identifies the components of health-related fitness. And S4, E2, 3, works independently for extended periods of time.
All right, so for our health-related fitness activity, we're going to work on our cardiovascular endurance. And by doing that, we're going to get our dance on. So the next slide, you're going to see first an example of some of our favorite dance moves and some other people's favorite dance moves. And then you're going to have a chance to get your own dance on in the following video. Now it's your turn, so go ahead and follow along with the dances on the screen.
Shake, you wishing you, You better dance. Let's make the night. You won't remember. I'll be the one. You won't forget.
Okay, so for our first activity, this is a little activity I like to call 1 bounce, 2 bounce, 3 bounce. All right, so in this activity, we will be working on keeping the ball or sock, whatever you have, consistently bouncing without losing control. All right, so the easiest way to keep the ball or sock under control is to not allow the ball to travel higher than your chest or neck area. To make it more challenging, however, you can bounce the ball or sock past your head or at a high level. Another challenging way to, present more is to travel around in some general space, keeping the ball up. So on the next slide, as soon as the timer starts, you're going to keep whatever you have bouncing for the first minute, and we are going to stay stationary, keeping that ball between our chest and neck area. So remember some cues, keeping our elbow in, our wrist is facing up towards the sky. When the ball comes back down, we're going to catch the ball with the flat end of our paddle, and we want to try and stay consistent as best we can. So we'll go ahead and get started. All right, we're staying stationary, keeping that ball bouncing between our chest and neck for the first minute here. Just like the video in the top left as I'm doing. Unfortunately, I did not have a regular ping pong or table tennis paddle, so I got creative and used a good old cutting board as my paddle today. It's got a flat surface. I was able to find a ping pong ball, so we'll use that. Off to a great start here. Remember, keep that elbow in close to your body. Wrist facing up towards the sky. Catch that ball on the way back down. Keep it under control. Good work, everyone. Good work. About 10 more seconds here with this one. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, this time we're going to make it more challenging. We'll keep the timer going. And we are trying to see if we can get that ball a bit above our head. Ball or sock, use that high level, and we'll go for another minute here. The video in the middle here should help you guys out. Same cues, we're just adding a little bit more force like we've talked about in the past to our paddle, making sure that ball gets to a higher level, keeping it under control as best we can. 30 more seconds here. Good work, everybody. Everybody's keeping those elbows in. And very consistent. We got about 15 more seconds here with this one. 10 more seconds. On our next one, we're moving around a little bit. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. All right, we're going to keep it going here. For the last minute, We have 2 more minutes here. For this one, we're going to move around in some general space. All right, we're going to make sure we keep our elbows in, catch that ball on the way back down. We're staying consistent. So we'll go ahead and get started. Around in some general space here, keeping that ball under control. Keep those elbows in, those wrists up. Good work, everybody. Good work. 25 more seconds on moving around. Good work, everybody. Everybody's doing the cues really well. All right, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And for the last minute, you guys can choose whichever type of bounce you want to use, whether it's staying stationary, keeping it at a mid-level, staying stationary, keeping the ball at a high level, or just moving around. Try and get all three in if you can for this last minute here. 40 seconds left. Remember those cues, keep those elbows in. Just facing towards the sky. Catch that ball on the way back down. I'm staying consistent all the way through. 30 seconds left. Good work, everyone. Good work. Seeing a lot of people keep those elbows in. That's great. Great work. See if you can move around a bit and keep that ball at a high level. Challenge yourself a bit. There you go. 10 more seconds here. Finish strong. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good work, everybody. We'll go ahead and move on to the next activity.
Okay, so for activity 2, we're going to be working on forehand and backhand. So for the first part of this activity, you will be striking your object forehand in the forehand pattern to a wall. This is also called the sidearm pattern. You can use any ball that can be bounced off of your paddle. And then after some practice, you will take a few steps back and try from a farther distance. And then after that, you are going to learn the backhand, which is similar to the forehand. There's just a different movement pattern, which will be explained in the next slide. Okay, so for the first 2 minutes, you're going to take your racket and any ball that you have that can bounce off of it, and you're going to practice the forehand pattern. For this, you keep your paddle flat and your wrist will be stiff. You keep your non-striking side to the wall, and then you will step with the non-striking side as you hit the ball. You will have 2 minutes to work on this. And while you are completing this activity, if you find that it is too easy, you may take a few steps back during this time to challenge yourself. So you're gonna have 2 minutes to do this. Make sure you got that flat paddle. That'll help you be able to strike to the wall. Keeping that wrist nice and stiff. You want to have a loose wrist. You want to be able to control the ball and where it's going. Good job, everyone. Thank you. got a minute 15 left. Keep practicing. Good job, everyone. Got a minute left. If you're struggling, you can drop, you can bounce the ball and then hit it. That will help out too. Like I said earlier, if you need to challenge yourself, create more distance between yourself and the wall. About 30 seconds left. Keep it up. Really try to focus on these cues for the last 10 seconds of this. Three, two, one, and stop. Good job, everyone. Okay, so now we're going to learn the backhand. This is a little different because you are going to strike from the same side that you're striking with. So as you can see in this video, I'm using my right arm to strike, so my right side is going to be towards the wall. Like with the forehand, you're going to keep a flat paddle and have a stiff wrist. So you're going to practice the backhand for 2 minutes. And like I said earlier, if it's too hard for you to hit it while dropping, you can drop it and let it bounce and then hit it. We got 2 minutes and you may begin. Remember, keep that paddle flat. That'll help you control where your ball is going to. Keep that wrist nice and stiff. You don't want to lose wrist, you want to be able to control it. Good job, everyone. Remember, you're on the same side that you're striking with. That's the difference with the backhand and the forehand. Okay, got about a minute left. If this is too easy, take a few steps back, try from a farther distance. You're gonna take more of a force to get into that wall from farther back. Good job, everyone. Almost finished. We got 30 seconds left. Really focus on these cues of the backhand. About 10 seconds left now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. Good job, everyone. Okay, so for the second part of activity 2, you're going to create wall targets while practicing both the forehand and the backhand. So you will have 3 targets on the wall at differing levels. So you're going to have your targets at a low level, a mid level, and a high level. You will take a few steps back and practice hitting the targets with both the forehand and the backhand movements. Okay, so remember the cues for the forehand: have that flat paddle, stiff wrist, keep the non-striking side towards the wall, and step with your opposite foot. And the backhand cues: Keep the paddle flat, keep your wrist stiff, and you're going to be stepping and keeping your same striking side to the wall. And you're going to practice hitting at differing levels, like you can see in the GIF right here. You may choose if you want to do the forehand or the backhand. You can switch it up. You can do it the entire time. It's all up to you. You got 3 minutes to practice, and you may begin. Good job, everyone. Remember the cues for both the forehand and the backhand. Really focus on hitting those targets. I got about 2 minutes. If you want to challenge yourself, change to a different pattern. If you're doing the forehand, go change to the backhand. Vice versa. Really try to practice hitting at different levels. Don't just stay on one level. Try to really hit the targets at all levels. Good job, everyone. Almost down to a minute. I got a minute left. And like I said, you can change up which pattern you're using. Really challenge yourself. We got about 40 seconds left. Good job, everyone. You're going to be future tennis stars in no time. Okay, 20 seconds left. Really try to hit one at each level. Go for the high, the mid, and the low. Got 10 seconds left. Two, one, and stop. Good job, everyone. Now we're going to move on to activity 3.
So for activity 3, we're going a minute to win it. This activity, we will find multiple objects and use to see what we can keep their object in there for 60 seconds rounds. Be sure to use the cues, which include grip, bend, something, firm wrist, strike, flat, and strike. So find your object. Ready, set, go. Seconds. Make sure you're using those cues: grip, bent wrist, firm bent knee, firm wrist, strike, and flat paddle and strike. Three, two, one. All right, so now pick up your other object, which is probably a sock. Ready, set, go. That paddle flat, I'm gonna hit the ball or whatever object you're using. About 10 more seconds. All right, now we're going to be moving on to our third object, probably a tennis ball, ping pong. You can choose. Ready, set, go. Five more seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right, stop.
Okay, so for our first question, for our review here is, what are the cues for keeping the ball or sock, whatever you use today, up in the air for a period of time? I'm going to give you guys about 30 seconds to come up with an answer. Go ahead and think about that for a couple seconds here. All right, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's see what you guys said. Here's our answer. All right, remember, we're going to keep that elbow in, our wrist facing towards the sky, slightly tap the ball, and stay consistent throughout.
All right, so our next review question is, why is cardiovascular endurance so important? I'm going to give you about 25 to 30 seconds to think of your answer. All right, about 10 more seconds. Three, two, one. We said it's important because it reduces your risk of developing heart disease by increasing the efficiency of your heart.
All right, so then we got, why is drinking water so important? I'll give you about 30 seconds. You gotta think about that one hard. It's not just because the water bottle looks cool. There's more to it, why we put it into our body. It's not good for the lungs. Well, actually it is, but it's not gonna be our main focus. Oh, there goes the timer. And we got drinking water can prevent dehydration, which is very important.
All right, for next class, we're going to be working on striking with long implements such as bats, hockey sticks, golf clubs, and etc. You're going to need loose and comfortable clothing, closed-toed shoes, some water, and of course, all of your excitement because it's the last class of the year.